the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the Lamb of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, today Jesus Christ ascend into heaven. Let Jesus Christ fill our hearts that ascend too, for doing our mission. Let Jesus Christ fill our hearts that we love our neighbor by doing our own missions. Let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. All together, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Gladden us with holy joys, Almighty God, and make us rejoice with devout thanksgiving, for the ascension of Christ your Son is our exaltation. And where the head has gone before in glory, the body is called to follow in hope, Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In the first book, Theophilus, I dealt with all that Jesus did and taught until the day he was taken up, after giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles whom he had chosen. He presented himself alive to them by many proofs after he had suffered, appearing to them during 40 days and speaking about the kingdom of God. While meeting with them, he enjoined them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father, about which you have heard me speak. For John baptized with water, but in a few days you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit. When they had gathered together, they asked him, Lord, are you at this time going to restore the kingdom to Israel? He answered them, it is not for you to know the times or season that the Father has established by his own authority. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, throughout Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. When he had said this, as they were looking on, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him from their sight. While they were looking intently at the sky as he was going, suddenly two men dressed in white garments stood beside them. They said, Men of Galilee, why are you standing there looking at the sky? This Jesus, who had been taken up from you into heaven, will return in the same way as you have seen him going into heaven. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Response: God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord.
God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord.
All you peoples, clap your hands, shout to God with cries of gladness. For the Lord the Most High, the Awesome, is the great King over all the earth.
God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord.
God mounts his throne amidst shouts of joy, the Lord amidst trumpets blast. Sing praise to God, sing praise. Sing praise to our King, sing praise.
God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord.
For King of all the earth is God, sing hymns of praise. God reigns over the nations, God sits upon his holy throne.
God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, may the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation resulting in knowledge of him. May the eyes of your hearts be enlightened, that you may know what is the hope that belongs to his call, what are the riches of glory in his inheritance among the holy ones, and what is the surpassing greatness of his power for us who believe, in accord with the exercise of his great might, which he worked in Christ, raising him from the dead and seating him at his right hand in the heavens, far above every principality, authority, power and dominion, and every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the one to come. And he put all things beneath his feet, and gave him as head over all things to the church, which is his body, the fullness of the one who fills all things in every way. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had ordered them. When they saw him, they worshipped, but they doubted. Then Jesus approached and said to them, "All power in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And behold, I am with you always until the end of the age." Brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
There was this saying that word push and example pull. Okay? Word push and example pull. Someone push and someone pull. The word push, the example pull. It adds also that any Christian walking or any Christian living walking is a Bible walking. That even though he or she never quoted any verse from the Bible, he is a walking or she is a walking Bible. It means that, my dear brothers and sisters, even if you speak too much, but your actions contradict to what you are saying, nothing will happen. Today we are celebrating the feast of our Lord Jesus Christ who is ascended to heaven. Happy feast day to all of us, to the ascension of our Lord Jesus Christ. Kindly greet each one of you. Sit beside you. Happy feast day for our ascension of our Lord.
Happy feast.
Something that nothing happened. Happy feast day to all of us, my dear brothers and sisters. And this is a very important feast to all of us. Before it is celebrating a Thursday, but for all of us that we are in this kind of situations, it is in holy obligations. As we are celebrating the feast of our Lord Jesus Christ who has ascended into heaven, we heard in the Gospel that Jesus Christ gathered all his disciples around him in Galilee. No? In Galilee. It was his last appearance, physical appearance to his disciples before he ascended into heaven, before ascended to the Father, and not only for his Father, but also our Father. His ascension is a sign of his life here on earth is ended. His sufferings here on earth is ended. So that's why it gives to all of us that our life, our sufferings also here on earth has an end. His ascension is not
a farewell party. That come, everybody. Now I will go. I will go to abroad. I will go to anywhere. And we have the party. No. This ascension is not a farewell party. But it has an unfinished business. He shows everything to the disciples. But to the next generation, that coming is not yet. So that's why very important his ascension, that transmitting a message to his disciples what he wants to do to all the people in the next generation. That's why it is not a farewell party. It is has an unfinished business, that his mission is entrusted to the disciples, not only for the few, but to the many, to all of us. And he said, remain in me. What is this word, remain in me? He is not physically, he is absent in the presence of the disciples. But later on, the Holy Spirit comes. Next of this solemnity of the feast of our Lord Jesus Christ who ascended into heaven is the Pentecost. The Holy Spirit will come down. Because the mission of our Lord Jesus Christ is to tell the world that there is a Father who loves us. And after his mission, the Holy Spirit continues to tell all of us that there is a Father who loves us in the presence of the Holy Spirit. Remain in me. It does not mean that he is living and not with us anymore, because the Holy Spirit comes. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit is one God. They are one. What are this mission? First, is to witness to Christ in the world. Again, to witness to Christ in the world. In Matthew 5, chapter 5, verse 8, it says that your light must shine into the world, and they may see the good deeds you have done to glorify the Father. And what is this light? This celebration, our celebration in the Holy Eucharist, is a kind of light to others, that we are loving, giving, have a concern, have a care to each other. Our light deep in us, it must shone to others by in good deeds, good action, not only a word, a mere words. It must be pushes. It must be propagated. Not by doing an example that pull us down and pull the people down. Our words must be an inspiration to others. Our example must also be an inspiration to others, so that others may have courage to do, even if they are weak. They could be able to see the light. They could have a strength because of your good example, because you are the walking Bible. You are mere Christ, the hand, all of being Christ. Christ is in you because of your good deeds and example. The second is what we call, we have to preach the good news that all of us has redeemed by Christ. In what sense? How to preach the good news if we don't know how to preach and what to preach? There are an announcement, a mini announcement from this church. Let's say, for example, who would like to become a catechist? Who would like to become a catechist? Willing to undergo trainings, willing to undergo instructions, educations. Because what we will be given is a kind that comes from the Word of God, that being learned and believe in us, so that we can give a word and a good example to others. That is a way of preaching on the good news, on the gospel. And the other one is to show our life, that Jesus Christ, to show our love, so that Jesus Christ is always with us. But how? For example, let's say, if you are working in a private and a public places and public sectors, use the time in a right usage. Don't accept any bribe. That is showing love to our Lord Jesus Christ and doing good to others. If you are a parent, be a parent. If you are a teacher, be a teacher. If you are a professional, be a professional. Because that is the gift, that is a gift, talent, skills that God gave to you. Don't destroy that talent that being given to you through the power of the Holy Spirit in order for you to grow as a good Christian. The fourth one is what we call sincerely making other like you. No? Making other like you. Not to be like you, but like you, who is doing good. In what sense? Genuinely have an interest to others. How to do it? Have an interest to others. Show an interest to others so the others have interest on you. Smile. And smile begins smile. Smile. And the world smile at you. Call the people by their name. Because the sweetest name that ever heard by the people is the sweetest sound that ever heard by the people is their name. And this is what we call also that sincerely make the people important by saying something nice to them. There are a lot of things, my dear brothers, in doing our own missions, good missions, that Jesus Christ says, show your light to the world. In the gospel, in the readings, it says to all of us, believe what you heard, what you read. Teach what you believe and live it. Amen. Please all stand and let us profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. And in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord,
was conceived of the Holy Spirit,
born of the Virgin Mary,
suffered under Pontius Pilate,
was crucified, died, and was
buried. He descended into hell.
On the third day, He rose again from the dead.
He ascended into heaven,
and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty.
From there, He will come to judge the living and the dead.
I believe in the Holy Spirit,
the Holy Catholic Church,
the communion of sins,
the forgiveness of sins,
the resurrection of the body,
and the life everlasting.
Amen. Brothers and sisters, let us pray to the Father who raised His Son from the dead and seated Him at His right hand in glory, that He may help us to follow His path in this life and so come to share His glory in life to come. Our response be, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Pope Francis, Bishop Aldo, bishops, priests, religious and laity, that through fervent prayer and an ardent desire for God's kingdom, they may continually grow in the knowledge of Jesus so as to announce Him effectively to His flock. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who will be baptized, that they may be blessed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Christian parents and teachers around the world, that they may teach the children under their care to observe the commands of the Lord and thus helps them to grow up as children of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For each one of us on this Ascension Day, that through prayer and reading of the Holy Bible, we may discover God's plans for us, especially in the time of suffering and accept it wholeheartedly. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a speedy end to the conflict between war-torn places and the suffering of their people. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us include also all the prayers and petitions, intentions that still in our mind and our heart, especially to our loved ones, to those people who ask our prayer. In the moments of silence, let us include all of them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we praise you for the love bestowed on us every single day of our life. Help us with your Holy Spirit to deepen into the knowledge of your Son, Jesus, and to announce him to all around us. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
My sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands with the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for the good of all his holy church.
We offer sacrifice now in supplication, O Lord, to honor the wondrous ascension of your Son. Grant, we pray, that through this most holy exchange, we too may rise up to the heavenly realms through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For after his resurrection, he plainly appeared to all his disciples and was taken up to heaven in their sight, that he might make us sharers in his divinity. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with your angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness, make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The Mystery of Faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Aldo our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have blessed you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by the divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Sisters and brothers, let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Oh,
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are the called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body of Christ bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who allow those on earth to celebrate divine mysteries, grant, we pray, that Christian hope may draw us onward to where our nature is united with you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Kindly be seated for some announcement. Reverend Father Matthews Francis Carmelite, the former Vicar General of Abona, is critical and hospitalized in Kerala. Kindly keep him in your prayers. We welcome the Cerro Malabar Bishop, Mar Anthony Prince Panigaden, who will be with us a few days. We wish him a happy stay. On May 20 and 27, the Spanish Mass will be in the Holy Family Hall. On 25th May, Thursday at 6:30 p.m., English Mass will be in the Holy Family Hall. In preparation for Pentecost, the 9 days novena to the Holy Spirit will be before the evening Mass from 19th to 27th of May. Charis Kuwait, along with other ecclesiastical movements in Kuwait, has organized the Pentecost Night Vigil at Our Lady of Arabia Parish Amadi on 25th of May, Thursday from 10 p.m. to 26th, Friday at 6 a.m. Those who are in need of transportation, please give your name and number to the parish office. On May 31st, Wednesday, the 6:30 p.m. Mass inside the church will be followed by candlelight procession and the Grand Rosary to be recited in various languages at Tagroto. All are invited to join. And due to the soaring summer temperatures and to avoid any casualty, we have decided that burning of candles will be gradually discontinued. Meanwhile, we are planning an eco-friendly electrical candles, which will be introduced in the coming months. Kindly bear and cooperate with us. Prayer for the Synod. We stand before you, Holy Spirit, as we gather together in your name, with you alone to guide us. Make yourself at home in our hearts. Teach us the way we must go and how we are to pursue it. We are weak and sinful. Do not let us promote disorder. Do not let ignorance lead us down a wrong path, nor partiality influence our actions. Let us find in you our unity, so that we may journey together to eternal life and to stray from the way of truth and what is right. All this we ask of you, who are at work in every place and time, in the communion of the Father and the Son, forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads for God's blessing. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May he show his face to you and have mercy. The Lord bless you. The Lord keep you. May he show his countenance and give you peace. The Lord bless you. And may the Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration is ended. Go and proclaim the good news of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.